And are these from the Mexico City?
Mexico City, correct.
Why did they come?
They were invited by La Asociación Los Bomberos, used to be part of the 9/11 memorial.
But what was their interest in obviously visiting America, but do they have maybe opinions about why they wanted to be here today?
Well, the invitation came out because after what happened in Houston, they're friends of mine. I go to Mexico, I do a lot of training for them. They wanted to go help. That was the main reason. So they called me and said, hey, how can we help? What can we do over there? But there was no way for us to send anybody over there anymore. So after that request by them to come and help us, I said, hey, you know what? We're going to have a memorial. Why don't you come over? And then after that, now it's creating a better gathering with them in regards of training. So we're going to be sharing our training, how we train in L.A.
Oh, really?
So we're bringing 100 of them coming in October 16th through the 24th. And then after that, probably we're going to be going over there as well to do some training for them. He is Ismael. He's like the president of the union for us here. So he's the representative for that, Ismael Figueroa. And his crew.
And his crew?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Mr. Figueroa?
Hi.
And Mr.
Ricardo Castillo.
Castillo?
Roberto Velasco, a sus órdenes.
Armando Segura. Armando Segura.
What is there from the first responders in Mexico City that we may learn from them?
Well, they experienced a big earthquake on September 19, 1985. In fact, one of them, he was part of that rescue back there. So their structures is totally different to us. But I think that we can get from them, even though they don't have all the equipment, they have a big heart. Big heart. They can go, they can work, they can do everything. That's the main thing. They have a big heart.
Is terrorism a problem in America del Sur?
You know what? I believe actually it's more the drugs, drug cartels. The main problem over there, kidnappings and that kind of stuff.
They had a problem in Argentina, as you recall. There was a big explosion in Argentina. Are they concerned about counterterrorism?
Como la explosión, lo que algo que pasó en Argentina, que si ustedes se preocupan algo de terrorismo o algo así.
Sí, tenemos ahí, nosotros la policía, no tanto los bomberos.
It's more the police, not really the firefighters.
What's the earthquake propensity for something to come again in Mexico City?
Well, they just had an 8.1 earthquake a few days ago. It was on the south, so it is huge, really big. Lots of earthquakes in Mexico. Very, very often.
Me pregunta qué tan seguido común son los terremotos. Le digo, allá tiembla muy seguido.
It's just like here in L.A. Earthquakes are pretty often. They're used to it.
Will they go into a building that's damaged by an earthquake that could be at risk of collapsing like occurred on 9/11 at the World Trade Center? Will they go into a building that could collapse on them?
I'm not them, but I'm going to say yes, and I'm going to ask them this one. Yeah. Pregunta que si algo llegara a suceder como lo que pasó en septiembre 11, que si ustedes estarían dispuestos a entrar a un edificio y ayudar a gente.
Claro, es nuestro trabajo. Sí.
They would.
Yes, oh yes.
How about the LA Fire Department? How about any American fire department going into to make a rescue where they know that their own peril?
Well, you know what? Everything we do every day here in LAFD is risks our life. Every single thing. And we do it because that's our job, because we are prepared, we're ready for that. No matter how simple it is or how complex, LAFD is ready.
Mm-hmm. And does the Mexico City Fire Department share that?
Me preguntó que si mi departamento estaba listo y preparado para alguna situación catastrófica o si entraríamos a alguna situación muy fea. Le dije que siempre lo hacemos en todo momento, es algo que es nuestro trabajo. Que si ustedes harían lo mismo.
Sí, claro.
Yes, of course. Yes, of course, they would. They would.